Kim, what is on your radar?
Show me your papers. More and more Americans and people across the globe are hearing these ominous words. People are being required to show proof of vaccination or be denied the ability to dine peacefully in restaurants, hold jobs, or even attend school. Earlier in December, several GOP lawmakers in the New Jersey State Assembly were denied access to the assembly chamber for refusing to show proof of vaccination.
You see this?
See it?
See this, folks? Denying us entry into our house.
This is America.
This is America. An illegal procedure, voting procedure they're relying on. It was deemed illegal, and they're enforcing it.
The state police are the best in the world, but they report to the executive branch, and how outrageous a governor to turn the state police on the
members of the legislature. This is tyranny, folks. America, see what's happening here.
Putting our heroes up here.
See what's happening, America.
That's right. Members of the minority party were blocked from representing their constituents and voting on legislation for refusing to adhere to a rule that was arbitrarily created by a commission. This was overturned by an appellate court, as there's nothing in the Constitution that requires proof of vaccination to vote. But they tried, and that should alarm all of us. If these were lawmakers of the Democratic Party who were blocked from entering the chamber to vote, we'd likely have seen endless news about voter suppression, and it would have been voter suppression. It is voter suppression. We intrinsically understand how wrong it is to block people from voting. We view voting as a basic right within a democracy, something we hold dear. Scenes of lawmakers locked out of chambers, be they Democrat or Republican, or scenes of hundreds of people busting into the Capitol to prevent a vote from happening shakes us to our core. We know it's wrong. It's an assault on our democracy. But we don't seem to have that same intrinsic understanding when it comes to other things, like the right to an education. Many people advocate for bettering education for all children. Many people understand the disparity for people in poor communities who have to send their kids to underfunded schools. But unlike the United Kingdom, for example, the U.S. does require many children to be vaccinated in order to access the public school system. The U.K. doesn't have this sort of requirement, not even for polio or measles. In this country, we require them, but there have always been ways to seek exemptions. However, increasingly, more and more states are banning religious exemptions, leaving parents who object to either succumb or educate their kids at home, which often leads to a lower quality education. And COVID has only escalated this issue. In Los Angeles, where I am now, the school district attempted to require vaccinations for all students 12 and older coming back from Christmas break. But because 30,000 students are out of compliance, the school board has had no choice but to delay the mandate until the fall of 2022. They at least came to their senses, realizing that 30,000 students can't be left to at-home online schooling when many have blue-collar working parents who wouldn't even be around to watch after them. Now, Los Angeles is an example of mass disobedience that ended up forcing the government to bend to the will of the people. But what happens to the children in areas where there isn't this much resistance? Those kids just get left behind with low-quality education. And many people say, oh, well, it's their ignorant parents' fault. Maybe they should believe science. Which echoes the same lines given about children attended poorly funded schools. Oh, well, it's their lazy parents' fault. Maybe they should get a job. All of this moral posturing does is harm innocent children and holds them back from gaining an equitable education. Now, maybe you don't think dining in a restaurant is a human right. Maybe you view it as more of a luxury. But historically, no one has ever been on the right side of history when choosing to ban certain peaceful people from entering facilities and participating in society. Recent video was taken of a child, maybe 5 or 6 years old, and his mother being kicked out of an Applebee's for not having proof of vaccination. Other patrons of the restaurant were appalled as the police yelled out, "Unless you have vaccination cards, you have to exit the restaurant. If you leave voluntarily, you will not have charges pressed against you. Otherwise, you will be arrested for trespass. This will be your only warning." Now, this isn't only happening in the U.S. It's been happening more severely and for longer across Europe. Videos have been circulating of police in Germany, France, and Italy interrupting peaceful patrons of restaurants, hair salons, and other places, asking them for their papers. In Canada, people can't fly or take trains to visit loved ones without showing their papers. Fauci, who mentioned the same thing could be happening here in the U.S., has now backtracked, saying he didn't necessarily support domestic airline mandates, just said it's on the table. But historically, he's flip-flopped so many times, it's hard to know what's true anymore. And this is where we are as a society. People believe it's their right to know the status of others and that their right supersedes any other human rights others may have claim to. People believe their right to know the status of others is more important than the right to vote, legislate, be educated, or even participate in society. People believe they have the right to limit the freedoms of others in the name of safety. Freedoms have been limited, groups segregated, and wars have been waged because a frightened public screamed for safety. Treating others as dangerous and dirty has led the human race to do many terrible things. We know these vaccines aren't stopping the spread, and even if you want to argue that they technically limit spread to some degree, it's obviously arbitrary, and real-world data is showing that nothing is stopping this virus. And even if the vaccines did stop the spread and worked the same way measles or polio vaccines have worked, there's still no reason to ask a person what their status is. When I travel to areas of the world where people don't have access to good vaccines and medical care, where there's a high probability that a good number of people have not been vaccinated against diseases that I have been vaccinated against, I have never once asked someone if they are vaccinated. I believe my vaccines work, and because of that, I'm not at risk of contracting a disease from an unvaccinated person. It never once crossed my mind to ask a person in the Middle East or Central America what they have or have not been vaccinated against before I dined with them. Not once. It's the same reasoning the UK used when they banned mandatory vaccination decades ago. You take vaccines for your own health so that you yourself don't contract the disease. If you don't want to take a vaccine, it's your risk to take. If you take a vaccine and travel to an area of the world with low vaccination rates, you're safe. You're vaccinated. That's the point of them. Now, these COVID vaccines clearly do not work the same way as other vaccines, so it's a moot point. But even if they did, it's still a moot point. But what isn't moot is the fact that our freedoms are being limited and we're being pitted against one another and against our own government, and none of it is helping end this pandemic. And Robbie, it feels like as we've continued on with these different mandates, even as we know there is no dispute these vaccines don't stop the spread. I was on this show 5 months ago saying the vaccines don't stop the spread, and was told that I was basically, I was wrong, and I wasn't wrong. As we've now found out, months and months have gone by, these vaccines aren't stopping the spread, but the mandates continue. And now even Biden is, even though Fauci said I'm not against, I'm not for or against these domestic airline mandates, and then Biden comes out and says, well, if my team tells me to do it, I'm going to do it. It feels like punishment now for noncompliance rather than science.
Absolutely. Punishment for noncompliance, and they're doing it because they can. They being, the government policymakers implementing this. The more power, the more they can boss us around and get away with it, the more power they ultimately have. Rochelle Walensky admitted, I was just seeing this on Twitter a few minutes ago, when she's talking about this changing the quarantine period, she actually admitted, she's like, look, we didn't think people were going to really put up with the 10-day period anymore, because now that so many people are getting it, it's going to be really inconvenient, so we shortened it to 5. Like, it's not science. So they did that because that's what the public will allow. So, but that tells you that they think the public will allow, is okay with, is broadly on board with requiring vaccination in a broad, variety of circumstances. I'm not on board with that. You're not on board with that. But they think they can get away with it. And that's what's most disappointing to me, because I expect government to push the limits, to require things. But I also hoped, I guess naively, that more people would say absolutely not. Or I guess they're saying that, in red states, in parts of the country, but not in the parts of the country where I live.
That is the one thing during this entire 2 years of the pandemic. I was looking back at even just some of my old videos from my show on YouTube. And I the one thing I've gotten wrong, and now everybody's been wrong to some degree, some more wrong than others, but one thing I've gotten wrong was I really believed that the American people would not tolerate this. When people would say to me, Kim, they're going to come out with mandates. Kim, they're going to force vaccinations on us. Kim, they're going to require papers. I was like, no, guys, come on. It's not going to be that. No way will Americans, freedom-loving Americans, tolerate passports and mandates. And I was wrong about that. And that has been the most jarring and frightening thing about this pandemic, is how many people have just said, okay, fine. And as Israel now is now looking at the fourth dose of the vaccine, because they're not getting the spread under control. Once again, it's starting to climb in their country, and they're saying, oh crap, what are we gonna do? So now they're saying 4 doses to stop the spread. It's like 3 masks to stop the spread, 4 doses to stop the spread. And
no, I'm in the same boat. Yeah. I thought there would be no appetite for enforcement. But what I didn't realize is that the government just, you know, just puts enforcement off to the people. Right. So right, there aren't, you know, right. Police are not roaming the streets looking for unvaccinated people or unmasked people. That is not happening. It's a softer totalitarianism. Where other citizens are, you know, are reporting you, where the person asks you right. at the door of the restaurant or the bar or whatever, it's the citizenry doing it, and in some cases they're being forced by the government doing it because it's government policy, but there's no just like let's not comply, right? That's not happening. Right. Now people are complying.
Yeah, it's a very frightening thing that we're living in right now. But one thing that has made me wonder about the domestic airline mandate, if they go in that direction, I just think that certain states like Florida and Texas, I mean, they are just not going to tolerate that. I don't know what they can do about it, but mm-hmm. that would be, I think, the thing that would really turn some of these states and say, you are preventing our citizens now from flying around and visiting loved ones like that. Is going way too far. Right. I don't think that states will tolerate that.
I hope the airlines don't tolerate it. I hope they stand up too. Yeah. I mean, they're kind of making a little bit of noise about mask mandates, but I hope they say no. You can't require our customers to be vaccinated. You don't. You know, we're not going to stigmatize the unvaccinated to the point where they're like not allowed to leave their homes. It's totally crazy to do that. So we'll have to see.
Especially now that we know Omicron was spread by fully vaccinated people
right.
traveling around the world.
Right.
That's who was spreading it. So
you're right. I still recommend that people get vaccinated so they protect themselves against severe disease. But it is not.
Right.
The case that you're protecting, you know, you're shortening
others.
The duration of the symptoms, just like you said, but you are still absolutely having vaccinated people spreading and contracting. That's like inarguable at this point. So it
right.
lowers
right.
the rationale you could make for having the mandates. Not that either of us would support them anyway, but it makes them even more ridiculous. So.
We'll see what the new year brings, right?
Yeah.
Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed for some sanity in the new year. That's my hope. And we'll have more rising, more sanity when we come back right after this.